Thank you very much for giving me this scope to speak on this bill, sir. Sir, I would have become happy if our government would have given sufficient effort before to improve this age-old system of medicine. Sir, in my opinion, it is nothing but another backdoor process of grabbing the power of another democratically elected autonomous body, which we have been witnessing since so many years. Sir, our present government has broken the previous record of bringing ordinance. So far my knowledge goes, previously it was maximum one or two ordinance per 10 bills. Now, so far my information goes, it has crossed more than 4 per 10 bills, and it's really shocking. Sir, I would like to put forward certain important points before this August House. Sir, in the year 2018, the Central Council of Homeopathy was dissolved based on certain allegations of corruption against the then existing Central Council of Homeopathy. And a board of governors consisting of 7 members was formed that time. Sir, most unfortunate part of the story is, till date, one post is lying vacant out of that 7 board of governors. Secondly, 1 year has passed, that vacant post is still lying vacant. The charge was there of corruption against the then existing Central Council of Homeopathy. But unfortunately, no charge could be proved in last 1 year. Sir, it was ensured that the democratically elected CCH will be formed in 1 year. Unfortunately, that election could not be held in the last 1 year. So I am becoming apprehensive whether in the coming year this government will be really able to hold the election or not. Sir, in 2019, again this bill was brought in Lok Sabha on 27th of June with a proposal of extension of duration of this Board of Governors for another 1 year. Sir, my certain observations and reservations are like this. First of all, the then Central Council of Homeopathy used to be formed by the process of a democratic election. But whenever there was a provision of Board of Governors, it was not known to all of us what was the criteria of being a member of Board of Governors. I don't know on what basis government selected the members of Board of Governors. So I once again believe it is nothing but the effort of grabbing the power and just giving the power to the hands of bureaucrats, nothing else. Sir, my question is, why the election could not be held in last 1 year? Sir, my question is, why the vacant post could not be filled up in last 1 year? Sir, my question is, homeopath system is an age-old system of our country. And so far my state of West Bengal is concerned, it is the pioneer of this homeopath system. But most unfortunately, not a single representative from this pioneer state of homeopathy, West Bengal, was given opportunity to be a member of this Board of Governors, sir. Sir, it's very unfortunate to note, when in our state of West Bengal, our present Chief Minister cum Health Minister, Madam Mamata Banerjee, when she took the charge as Chief Minister cum Health Minister in 2011, the then budget, health budget was only 682 crores. In 2011, and now in 2019 it has become 9700 crores. I repeat, 9700 crores. So it was an increase of nearly 1400 times, sir. And unfortunately, on the other side, in our country, the health budget is merely 1.5% of the total GDP. And moreover, we have seen that out of the total budget of AYUSH department, the homeopath gets only 13% of the entire house departmental budget. It is reflected by, as AYUSH stands for A for Ayurved, U for Unani, S for Siddha, U for Yoga, U for Unani, S for Siddha, and H for homeopathy. H comes last. The budgetary allocation for homeopath also comes last. It's only 13% out of the total Ayush departmental budget, sir. Sir, I would like to highlight certain important points of my own state. Status of medical officers of homeopathy in India. I must let you know the total post is 71 and the vacancy is 39, that is more than 50%. The CGHS wellness clinic vacancy in West Bengal, total created post was 10 and the vacancy is 6, so 60% is vacant there. Especially in the clinics like airport, two vacancies. In the clinics like Sembajar, two vacancies. In the clinic like Doverland, these clinics are very, very important so far their geographical distribution is concerned, but the posts are lying vacant, sir. Sir, as per the need of our, few more posts should be created specially for the places like Siliguri, Jalpaiguri, Asansol and Durgapur. Sir, I would like to let you know regarding the outreach camps, camp status in West Bengal. It is only 10. Where it should be at least 3 per district, that is for 23 districts it should be at least 69, sir. Finally, junior research fellows, senior research fellows, they should be given the importance, sir. Sir, if you go to our National Institute of Homeopathy, which is situated in Calcutta, you will start crying, I repeat, you will start crying. The situation is so horrible. The faculties are not there. Patient, hardly you like to go to that particular national institute to get treatment.
And please the same, conclude.
And the, yes, and the same condition is with the Shillong Institute, which is the best institute, which was supposed to be the best institute, is not, not in India. Sir, my humble submission, our government should give due importance to improve for the betterment of this age-old homeopath system instead of going for these bridge courses, as it was told by my previous speaker. Instead of improving this homeopath system, they are trying to run a bridge course by the process of which homeopaths, Ayurvedes, they are allowed to practice modern medicine, and then
thank you.
They neither thank become you. Homeopaths nor become allopaths.
Thank you.
So these points must be taken into consideration.
Thank you.
Thank you.